Hi officers, how's the Josh? Welcome to the second video on memory techniques, and today we are shooting in a different format because the techniques we are going to study requires this infrastructure. But before we begin guys, a quick announcement. Civils Daily has launched its Decimate Prelims program. This is the crash course for Prelims 2020, and the program starts on the 10th of January. The link of the program will be given in the description box, so do check it out. Now guys, before we discuss the techniques today, let us first go through this story. In the previous video, we talked about the PEG system, wherein we got this idea that the human brain is good at remembering stories, it is good at remembering images, it is good at remembering colors, sounds, maps, positions, locations, but it is not so good at remembering random facts and random numbers. So today we are going to study how random facts and random numbers can be remembered better. And before we come to the details of the techniques, this story we have to go through. Now this story has got two main characters. The first is Mr. Warren Buffett. Now you must already be aware of who Mr. Warren Buffett is. And also the second person is Miss Ellen DeGeneres. So Ellen also is a very famous personality. You must have seen her video clips on YouTube, and Warren Buffett, of course, you must be knowing. So guys, we begin with this story, which says that Warren Buffett saw a person collecting corn. Corn means makka, wo jo bhutta khate ho, that. So collecting corn at the shore of the Bell Sea. So Bell Sea karke koi samandar tha jiske shore pe, on the shore of which the person, somebody was collecting corn. The corn was sent to a bar to mint money for Warren. Now, Warren is a very rich person, a billionaire, and therefore this minting of money has been taken into this story. So, this corn was taken to a bar to mint money for Warren Buffett, who was sitting on an armrest. Now, because Warren is so rich, he doesn't need to work. So, while the money was being minted from the corn at a bar, Warren was sitting on an armrest. Armrest, guys, you must have seen on chairs. You have those wooden or plastic where you keep your arms. Basically, that is called as armrest, those places. So, armrest and painting a calf. So, Warren was happily sitting on an armrest and painting a calf in Auckland. Warren was in Auckland, where Ellen DeGeneres, Ellen had a hard time eating dal from a can. So this story, guys, I hope you have got a broad idea what it means. Basically, you have to remember this story in as vivid way as possible. So the two main characters of your story is the billionaire Warren Buffett and the charming Miss Ellen DeGeneres. And the story says, Warren saw a person collecting corn at the shore of which sea? Bell Sea. This corn was then sent to a bar where it was used to mint money for Warren. And because Warren is so rich, he was simply sitting on the armrest. This armrest part is important. Sitting on the armrest of a chair and painting. What was he painting? He was painting a calf, and this was done in Auckland. And in this place, Auckland is in New Zealand, and in this place, Ellen DeGeneres, Ellen had a hard time, a difficult time eating what? Eating dal from where? From a can. So this story, guys, if you remember, you now know the 17 Governor Generals of India in their order. And how it is? Let us see. Warren. Warren stands for Warren Hastings. So this is the first Governor General. Then we come to this word, a person. Now this was the second Governor General, and this was John MacPherson. So the names that you use, the nouns or the verbs, whatever you are highlighting, these have to sound close to whatever you want to remember. So person sounds close to MacPherson. Next, this person was collecting corn. Corn means Cornwallis. Shore. Shore is John Shore. Next, the shore was of which sea? Bell Sea. So, Bell Sea is Wellesley. So, this is Wellesley. Then, again, we come to corn. This corn was sent. So corn is, again as cornwallis. Corn was sent to a bar. So bar means bar law. Now this governor general did not serve long enough to be very popular. So the name can be slightly difficult to remember. But if you can remember bar, Barlow will come. So Barlow, the full name is George Barlow. But if you can remember Barlow also, then also you can mark the answer at least. You can eliminate the choices. So we have Barlow, mint. Mint is Minto. Lord Minto. Then mint money for Warren. Warren means Warren Hastings. Who was sitting on an armrest. Now this again, just like George Barlow, is not a very popular governor general, and the name is not exactly armrest, it is Amherst, A-M-H-E-R-S-T, Lord Amherst. Painting, painting goes with Bentinck, Bentinck, and what was being painted? A calf was painting. So calf goes with Metcalf. Charles Metcalf. The next is Auckland. Auckland is Lord Auckland. This name itself, Lord Auckland. Where? Ellen. Ellen is Ellen Borough. B-O-R-O-U-G-H. Lord Ellen Borough. Next, hard time. So hard starts stands for harding. Harding. Next, we come to dal. Ellen was Ellen had a hard time eating dal. Dal stands for Dalhousie. Dalhousie. And last is can. This can stands for canning. So these were the 17 Governor Generals of India. And guys, if you try to remember these names just randomly, this is just very factual information which your mind will find it very difficult to remember. But if we have this kind of a method, this story, stories are easier to remember. And therefore, I hope this is a better way. You find it more interesting and easier to remember these factual information. So we have all these 17 Governor Generals. Second was Macpherson. Third was Cornwallis, fourth was John Shore, fifth was Wellesley, sixth was again Cornwallis, seventh was Barlow, eighth was Minto, Warren Hastings again, ninth, then we have Amherst, 10th, Bentinck 11, Metcalf 12, Auckland 13, Ellenborough 14, Harding 15, Dalhousie 16 and Canning 17. So guys, this is one of the ways in which you can remember the Governor Generals or any factual information for that matter. And this is the technique of mnemonics. Let me just erase something here. So this is the technique of mnemonics, guys. And mnemonics can have multiple variations. The first could be this story type which we have just seen. The second could be of acronyms. Now acronyms you are all very well aware of. For example, radar is an acronym, laser is an acronym, FBI, CBI, CID, NIA, NSG, whatever. So these are all acronyms and the full forms are easier to remember this way. Then there is something known as acrostics also. This term acrostics you don't need to remember, but the idea is that in acrostics you have a statement or a sentence and the first letter of every word means something. For example, if I have this sentence which helps me in remembering the solar system, the planets of the solar system, this statement, this sentence can be, my very educated mother just served us noodles. So I'm not writing the whole sentence, but the first letter of every word of this this sentence helps me in remembering these planets in their order. So M here, my stands for Mercury, very educated mother, V will be Venus, E will be Earth, M again will be Mars. Then just served us noodles. J stands for Jupiter, S stands for Saturn, U stands for Uranus and N stands for Neptune. So this is called as acrostics. And so guys, this was the whole idea of mnemonics, and you can have your own unique way of mnemonics also. You can have numbers, you can have rhymes, you can have music, whatever you can easily remember. And the main idea is that it should be able to help you remember things, remember facts and numbers more easily. So you can have your own permutations and combinations and experiment with the technique of mnemonics to have your own unique methodology. So guys, this was the way, one of the ways in which Governor Generals can be remembered. Now you may say that ki bhai ye to aasan tarika hai, this is very easy because we are just remembering the names, and perhaps even a 10th class student can do this. What if you also want to remember the years, the duration of office of these Governor General? So there's sequence we have in this technique, but also we want to remember the years, those numbers, when each of these Governor Generals was in office. So this also can be done, guys, and for this we need the major system, or the phonetic peg system, so to say. And in that system, what we do is we convert numbers into sounds. It is the sound that is important in that system. And for that, I'll need to have another story. I'll have to rub this entire thing and have a chart also to convert the numbers into sound. So please pause for a while, and then we can begin again once we have the story on the board. So guys, here we have the story, and this story contains all these words. From these words we can make out, we can elaborate what we are talking about. And the important thing to note is that these words are to be taken for their sound, not for the spelling. For example, if we say the word car here, we mean the car that you drive. It is not any other word that it means. It is just the sound that we are referring to. Although car is spelled C-A-R, the sound that we require is of this C, the K sound. And this K sound is shown by this this letter K. So you need to remember, we are talking about the phonetic peg system. Phonetic means it is the sound that is important and not the the spelling. So with this background in mind, let us go through our story. And the story begins with a daku. Now guys, daku, if you remember in old Hindi movies, Sunil Dutt movies, perhaps Sunil Dutt is the best daku look that one can get. I mean, that dhoti and kurta and the tilak and that pagadi and with the banduk, dunali banduk. So if you remember Sunil Dutt movies, he used to become daku very frequently. So you have a daku, but in Sunil Dutt movies, the daku used to be on a horse, but we have an economically better off daku. So this daku is in a car. So you remember a daku, somebody like Sunil Dutt, and then driving a car. But this car is not moving on road because perhaps traffic is too much. The car is flying, and the car is flying on top of a fish. Now if we talk about fish, we can think of ocean, and ocean means we can think of Bombay. So the daku is flying in a car on top of a fish, and the daku is going to Bombay. They are going to Bombay, the daku is going to Bombay to meet his best friend, Bur and Fur, the sound, BF here. So to meet his best friend, the best friend is a deaf person, he cannot hear, but he cannot hear, and the deaf person, the best friend, has got a seal, some kind of tattoo on his shoulder. So now this same tattoo which he has got on his shoulder is also on the sole of the footwear, whatever shoe or whatever footwear the person is wearing. That same seal is also on the sole of the footwear. And then this this best friend, he throws the footwear in the sky. So you need to remember the footwear going in the sky and hitting the dome of some building. Some building was nearby, and that footwear hits the dome of that building, and it falls down, falls on a neem tree, and this tree has got a knife. Now this N-I-F-E, it represents this sound knife, chaku. So like if you remember this kind of something, so this is like a knife. So this is the knife that we are talking about. Now this tree has got a chaku or this machete kind of a knife, dug into it, and this knife has got a mail. Mail means a letter. So, like this kind of a mail that tree has got, and that knife is digging into it. This mail, inside this mail is a matchstick. The matchstick with which you burn candles. This matchstick is in this letter, in this mail. Mail is the word that is important and not letter. That is why mail has been written here. So this matchstick is in this mail, and after taking out the matchstick, this Daku, he runs because he hears a roar. Roar means dharda. Dharda kaun hai? Sher dharta hai, jangli janwar dharte hain. So he hears a roar, and this roar came from the roof of the building, whatever building was nearby. So this roar came from the roof. Now this Daku who had this matchstick, he ran into the lush green forest or lush green grasses or whatever the bushes that were there. So this Daku rushes into the lush green bushes, and he has a hearty laugh because he has escaped the lion. So this whole story, guys, let us remind ourselves of it once again. We began with a Daku, and this Daku was in a car. This car was flying. It was not on road, it was flying, and it was flying on top of a big giant fish. From fish we can remember ocean, and from ocean we can remember Bombay. So this car was going to Bombay, this Daku was going to Bombay to meet his best friend. This best friend was deaf. Best friend was deaf, and he also had a seal on his shoulder. The same seal was on the sole of his footwear. This best friend threw his footwear, which hit the dome of a nearby building, and it fell on the tree, on the neem tree. Neem is important. It fell on the neem tree. That neem tree had a knife dug into it, a machete sort of thing. A knife. Knife is the important word. Knife dug into it, and that knife carried a letter. It was like this was the letter and this is the knife. This letter was there. Mail is the important word. This mail was there. In the mail was a matchstick. Match is the important word. In the mail was a matchstick. Now this Daku, he took out this matchstick, but as he took it out, he heard what? He heard a roar, and the roar came from where? From the roof. So probably a lion or a tiger or something of that sort was on the roof. And after hearing the roar, he got scared and he ran into the nearby lush green vegetation, whatever was there. So lush is the important word. He ran into the lush green vegetation, and then he had a hearty laugh. L-A-A-F is basically this laugh that I'm referring to. So he had a hearty laugh because he had escaped the lion. So this is our story, guys, and now we can convert this story into numbers, and for that we need a system, and this is the system which we are talking about in the major system, also known as the phonetic memory system, phonetic peg system, I'm sorry. So we have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9, and these numbers, each of these numbers, they represent a sound. So if I talk about 0, we can say that the 0 is circular like the sun, and also 0 is pronounced 0, and we have it like sun. So the sound that 0 is associated with in the system is z sound or z sound, whatever, and this s of the sun. So s or z. If you can notice, both of these sounds, they come out very easily. We don't need to move our tongue too much or lips too much to produce these sounds. Z, s. So it is easy. It is not like ma or pa, wherein your lips move, or la, wherein your tongue moves. So z, s, z, c, whatever. S and z are the two sounds associated with 0. And how do you remember it? 0 is like sun, so s, and 0 is pronounced as 0, so z. Next we come to 1. Now if we write 1, guys, in a small English alphabet, it will be like
Sir, there is one downstroke you make. So one downstroke here, and also you can have one downstroke to make the. So T and D have the sound of one. The, the. Similar sound phonetic system you need to remember. So the sound associated with one is T and D. Next we come to two. So just like we had one downstroke while writing one, if we have two downstrokes, we will have two. So two downstrokes will be like one and one, and if we join these, it will become an N, a small N, a small English letter N. So the sound associated with two is N, na sound, na. Next is three. We had two downstrokes with two, with three downstrokes we have three. So one, two, and three. And if we join these downstrokes, we get M. So the sound is ma. The sound with two is na. The sound with three is ma. With four, the word is F-O-U-R and it ends with R. So this you need to remember. Four is R, the word, the letter R, and the sound is R. Fifth is like if you open your palm, you get this L shape. So five fingers means this L shape. So five is L and the sound is la, la. If we come to six, now India is a cricket loving nation. If we talk about six, six means sixer. So if you hit a sixer, that means you are hitting a shot. So sixer is from a shot, but the chances of hitting this shot are less. So if I say in Hindi, it can be jab sixer ka shot hit hota hai to log khush hote hain, but iska chance bahut kam hota hai hit karne ka. So the sound that I am focusing on here is sh, sh, not sa. Sa was with zero. With six, we have sh, shot. We have ch, the chance of that shot is very less. And we have j, jab. Jab six ka shot hit hota hai, to log khush hote. So j, ch, and sh. So you see the movement of my lips and my tongue. It is very similar. The phonetics, the sound, sh, ch, and j, are with six. It is important to remember all these three. If we come to seven, now guys, there are two ways of remembering it. One can be like if you count till seven, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So counting till seven, even very small kids know. So you can say that even a KG student will know counting up till seven. So K, K and J sound. It is important to differentiate between the this J here is the sound of jab, the Hindi letter jab. This G here is not J, it is G. Gana, like you have Sare Gama Pada Nisa, these seven sounds. From these seven sounds, you can sing a song. So Gana, this is the G, that the G sound, and the K here is the K sound. So this is one way of remembering. The other way is if you see the English word K, it is like two sevens back to back. So we have a seven like this. If we tilt it a bit, it gets like this. And similarly, we can have another seven like this. So K sound and seven saat sur hote hain, sare gama paadha nisa. So these seven saat sur, they help us in singing a song. Gana gaane mein help hota hai. So this is G, not J. Please remember, this is a mistake which I did. This J here is J and this G is G. Next is eighth. Eighth, you can remember, like if we write in cursive, we write F like this. So eight is similar to, this F is similar to the eight. So the sound here is F, F, F. And the other sound that is very close to F, the lip movement, muscle movement of the mouth, is V, V, F, V. Now, how you can remember this verb is if you write in Roman numbers 8, it will be like, this is how you write it. So, you simply remove these three. You have V and the sound is V, V. If we come to 9, now 9 is very simple, guys. If we write it in English, we can first have, if we have a mirror image of 9 just exactly here, we can have like this. So P, and the sound will be pa 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 pa. And if we put it downwards, it will become like this. It will become a B, ba 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 ba. So these are the sounds, guys, which you need to remember. And if you can associate these sounds, if you can remember, this is the crux of the system. You have to mug these things up, but I suppose the logic which I have given, most of these things would be already imprinted in your mind. But with a bit of practice, you can remember all these sounds. And if you can convert these sounds to this story, you will get the figures which we are talking about, the duration when the 17 governor generals were in office. So let us do that. The first sound we have is duh. Duh. And duh sound, where do we have duh sound? So 1. This is 1. And the next sound that we have is k. Where do we have k sound? K. 7. The next sound is 7. Then we have a car, another k sound. So k is 7. And the next sound is r. If we come to the chart, r will be 4. So 4. So everything begins from 1774. Daku in a car means the year 1774. I hope you get this point. So how I converted the 1774, let me just talk about it in another manner. So 1774 was how I wanted to convert it, the beginning. So 1 stands for T or D. So I took D, D. I came to 7. 7 can be K or G. So I took K. With D and K, I get Daku. Then I come to 7, another K, and I come to 4, R. So K and R, K and R. So if you think car can be one of the options. So K and R. So Daku in a car is 1774. This is how I did. You can have your own different variations, and it is important that you have your variations, because these are words which come easier to me. There might be words which come easier to you. So that way you have to do. Next, if we come, guys, we have the sound fly. So F and L. F, find F is 8, and L 5. So we have 8 with F and 5. Why is not important, guys? It is only F and L that is important in this system. Now, another thing that you need to take into account in this system is we don't have vowels. So A, E, I, O, U, the sounds associated with these vowels are not taken into account when we do this system. It is only the consonant sounds that are there. So these sounds you need to remember, vowel sounds can be used in making these words. So A and U, Daku, when we said, D was the sound of consonant and A was a vowel. U again, K was the sound of a consonant, 7, and U was a vowel. So vowel sounds can be used to make these words, and consonant sounds, only these consonant sounds are for these numbers. The remaining consonant sounds you can again use to make these words like Daku, car, etc. So I hope you get a hang of this system. So we have fly. So F will be 8, F, L will be 5. So 85 is another. So we have from 1774 to 1785. This was the duration of the first Governor General. The next Governor General is Fish. First is F. F again stands for 8. And SH. SH is Sh. Sh sound came with 6. So we have 86. So from 85 was the first Governor General. From 85 to 86, we have the second Governor General. Next, we come to Bombay, and here the important words, the important sounds are B and M. Now guys, if we talk about B, the word, the letter, the number is 9, and if we talk about M sound is 3. So from 86 to 93, and we are talking about 1786 to 1793, we have the duration of office of the third Governor General. Next, we come to the next Governor General, that is B, best friend, B and F. B again is 9, F 8, F is 8. So 93 to 98 is the duration of the fourth Governor General. Next, Def, D and F. D 1, F 8. So we have come to the 1800s. Till now we were in the 1700s. Now we come to the 1800, and the second part of the year, this part will be Sir and L. Sir is 0, L is 5. 0, 5. So from 98 to 1805, we have the duration of the fifth Governor General. So guys, I hope if you can decode all of these, you will get the Governor General's duration also. So this is the way in which you can transfer number into sounds, and those sounds you can use to make words and weave them into a story. And then if whenever you want to decode them, just simply go back from the story using the sound to these numbers. So guys, that will be all in today's video. I tried my best to make this system as simple as possible. If there is any doubt regarding any aspect of the techniques which we have discussed, you can always ask me in the comment section. And you guys, as I have told you, you have to experiment with these systems. These are these may be new to you, and with practice these systems will become easier. So permutations and combinations, different ways are there in which you can have your own unique systems. And in case you have something interesting to share through which we can remember things better, maybe even more easy than these systems, please share in the comment section. Until next time guys, study well and take care. Jai Hind.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update from Civil's Daily.